national sports, sumo. Then please welcome these former small wrestlers. Let's give it up for them. Okay, so let's see what the small wrestlers do in practice in each stable. Small wrestlers practice from 6 o'clock to 11 o'clock a.m. in the morning, about 5 hours later, then training. And in the past, we are doing the Shiko stomping. In the past, Shiko, this is Shiko. In the past, when sumo was more of a religious ceremony, the stomping had the intention of calming down the evil spirits in the ground and to wish for the good harvest of rice. Wrestlers do stomping called Shiko as the first warming up exercise when they appear in the drill hall every morning. By doing so, they can strengthen their legs and loins and improve a sense of balance. They do 300 times Shiko before the training and 100 times Shiko after the training. So very slowly we do this every morning. The next is the Suri Ashi shuffling walk. So this is a training to master the feet movement during the match. He gets his center of balance low and moved forward with keeping his feet touching the ground. If he slip and fall during the match, they lose. Then that's why you need well-balanced movement to become a better small wrestler. Shiko and Suriyashi are the very basic but important training. They must do these exercises again and again every day to become a strong wrestler. Then to finish the training, they do this exercise. That is, they crash into each other repeatedly. It is called the Butsukari Geiko. At the end of everyday training, it gives the sumo wrestlers pain of all the moves during training. The Butsukari Geiko is the most important practice to develop them strong sumo wrestlers. It's significant for not only the wrestler who is pushing, but also the wrestler who is on the receiving end. Both of them strengthen part of their legs and loins, but gets a strong mind through that move. So these are part of the everyday practice for small wrestlers.
はい、then, これですね、ぶつかり稽古なんですけども、息を止めて押す人が押すんです。
止めて押すの。
はい。
So we, some small wrestlers stop their breathing and then push.
はい、で息をハーって途中で吐いてしまったり声がアーって出てしまうとゴロンゴロンされたり。
So if actually they breathe out or they say ha when you know the voice come out, usually they lose like they actually that falling down on the floor.
何回もアタックしていく感じです。
So actually we do that and ぶつかり稽古 the push hit together many times in the morning.20-30 times we actually crush each other in a day. Okay, いいですか？では次いきますよ。Then there's next explain about the rules of sumo. So the rule, how to win. The size of the sumo rings we saw the sumo rings, right? 見てきましたね。So this is like a big size, right? So the sumo bout, the wrestler wins.By pushing out the opponent from the ring. If you push out from the rope.
Ring out.
Right? Ring out. And then, or by getting the opponent's body, except the soles of feet, touch the ground.
That's.
Then they lose.
That's shoulder touch. Yeah,
so they touch the ground.
Back touch.
They lose. Yes. They lose. Wow. Except the sole.
Yeah.
So there are 82 different techniques.
Wow.
82 different techniques used to win the sumo match. And they are called kimarite. Those techniques is called kimarite. So today, we are going to show you the three most commonly used techniques, kimarite. The first one is the oshidashi, frontal push out. without grabbing the loin cloth. He didn't just push. Next, this is a push up. Then the next one, next one is a yori kiri. Frontal force out. This is the pushing out the opponent with grabbing. Did you see that he grabbed? Right? Yeah. So this is the different. First one just a push. Second one grab the loin. Then that is called yori kiri. Getting the hand, the loin cloth. Then number three, Number three. Finally, uwate nage, overarm throw. Overarm throw.
Okay.
So uwate nage is grabbing the opponent's loin cloth over his arm and just throw it. That is the uwate nage. So these are the common movement in sumo. There are also certain moves that are not allowed to do.
Next, not
allowed. This is called kinjite. Not allowed to do NG, no good. So it means a prohibited technique. Yes. Eight kinds of kinjite we are going to going to show four of them.
Four.
Okay, the first one is intentional grabbing of top knot or hair. Striking with fist.
No.
Not boxing.
The slapping with open hand is okay.
Not boxing. Sumo. Sumo is open.
Open is okay.
Okay.
Do you get disqualified if you use one of these?
それを禁じて使ったらもうダメ、今日はもう叱ろうってなる
わけ。やった方が負けになってしまいます。
Yes, they lose. Okay. Yes. If they use the 禁じてた場合はね、yes, they lose. Okay, number three, number three. Poking eyes with fingers.
No, danger.
Poking.
No.Danger.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
このベルトより上を蹴ったらダメです。
Actually, you they can kick an under here, under the belt is okay. They can kick it, but they cannot kick the upper body.
これは
OK, it's OK. This is one of the technique, but you cannot kick ね、the top, half top.Next one, chili chows. Show you, Bungo san, show you chili chows.
One, two, three, four, five.6, 7, 8.
So this is chili chozo. This is actually a ritual due to the sumo's connection with the Shinto religion. So that's why the sumo is very special. Shinto religion.
Yeah.
Shintoism. This is called chili chozo. Chili chozo expresses the oath to fight openly and squarely with the loin cloth only.Like a respect for their opponents, then so shall we do the chili chows together?
じゃあ皆さん一緒にやってみましょうかね。
Okay, would you like to try to do chili chows?
はい。
You have this?
はい。 One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, OK, thank you very much.
So actually you do, you did this. What does it mean?
これはですね、神社で手水舎という手を洗うとかですね。手を洗ってから、身を清めてからお参りするっていうのがあるんですね。それと同じ意味があったりします。
So, when we go to the shrine, there's a kind of the purification place where we actually wash. We cannot wash our body, so we actually wash our hands, showing that we are purified. Mm-hmm. So this movement is actually just like that we do in the shrine. Mm-hmm. This is actually we are pure.
で、チリチョーズのこれも same meaning ですね。一緒ですね。
So like ですね。
で、その後手をクラップ。
Then clap our hands, right?
これはですね、神社とかに行きますと、神前の前で。2回手を叩いたりするんです。これは神様を呼び起こしたりだとか、これからお願いしてしますよっていう合図みたいですね。それと同じ意味があったりします。
So when you go to the Shinto shrine, not the Buddhist shrine, we are going to the Shinto shrine after this actually. And you can see that the people twice they clap their hands. It's actually the calling out the God. They notice me. I'm now here to pray.Wake up the God, the calling the God. So it's actually the same kind of gesture the sumo wrestler do, like when the people go to the Shinto shrine.
その手を開いて、
and then open.
私は武器を持ってますよ。
And then no weapons. I don't have anything. No weapons. Look at me.
で、先生どうどうどうと戦
いますよっていう。Open and no weapons.
ね。あ、no no no no. プロフィテ。no no no. 危ないですね。で、はい、そういう意味があったりします。皆さん、で、僕らお相撲さんの時、これ何の意味も分からずにやったりしたと思って、ハンドジェスチャーだけ。
So actually we were the small wrestler, but we didn't understand what it means when we were the small wrestler.
皆さんにお伝えする機会できて、もう一回勉強し直して、意味を知ったりしました。
So actually we are working here to explain about the sumo to the, you know, the travelers or the some, you know, the people here.So we learned that what it means right now. So that's actually thank you. So, the Japanese people who love the sumo, watch the sumo, but then most of the Japanese people don't understand why they do this, you know. So maybe that you can understand all the sumo. So when you go back, you can teach.帰ってから teach したね。You can teach about the sumo.
あれ何だったの?
Your neighbor.